What's happening, ladies and gentlemen? This is Min for Architecture Inspirations. Today, I'm going to show you how to create an animated interior and exterior scene in Lumia. Let's get started. Since Lumia 11, we have a new effect called animated phasing. With this new effect, you can show and hide parts of the scene at specific times, which allows you to create animations of your design's construction process or an animated interior scene. Here I have a scene with a camera animation already set up. Now I will click here and add a phasing effect, which is located in the animation tab. Then I can click here to start editing my phasing effect. Here you will see the timeline at the bottom and the settings at the top. Next, I will click here to choose which objects I want to add to the phasing effect. When selecting objects, make sure you have the right category selected. In this case, I'll select all of the objects in the scene. To do that, I can select all categories. Then let's zoom out. Now I can hold Ctrl and drag to make a selection like so. Then I need to click on one of these nodes to add all of these objects in the selection. You can see the number of selected objects is updated. Now I'll click Done and preview the animated effect here. Or I can go back to the Movie tab and click Play to see how it looks. The animation is a bit too fast compared to the length of the whole clip. So let's go back to edit the animated phasing effect. Here I can change the duration of the phasing effect with this slider. You can see the duration indicated by the dark blue color on the timeline as I make changes to the duration. I will set it to about 3 seconds. I can also use the start time slider to control when the phasing effects will begin. Alternatively, I can move this bar in the timeline by dragging it like so. Let's go back to see the changes now. As you can see, the animation is slower now. However, it would look better if the terrain was present from the beginning, so I'll go back to the effect and edit the objects. Now I'll click on the terrain to remove it from the selection. There we go, that looks better. Let's take a look at the other settings in the phasing effect. Up here you can see the animation type is set to pop in, which causes the objects to appear from the object's center point. If you click on it, you will see a drop-down menu, and there are different animation types that you can use. These include the sky drop, which makes the objects fall from the sky, ground rise, which makes the objects rise from below the surface, and implode, which makes the objects fly towards the origin of the group. For this scene, I would use the ground rise effect. However, let's take a closer look at the effect. You can see that the ground rise effect ended a bit abruptly. To improve the animation a bit more, I can use the ease in settings. By default, it is set to 0. If you increase it all the way to 1, the objects will appear fast at the start, then slows down at the end. I'll set it to about 0.8. The next effect is stagger. This will stagger the order of when the objects will start to appear. Since our scene has so many objects, setting the stagger to max removes the ground rise animation completely because all of the objects move so fast. So I will reduce the stagger effect to about 0.8. We can also reverse the order of the objects by clicking the inverse stagger order here. That's a simple way of creating a phasing animation. Next, I use an interior scene to show you how to create a more complicated phasing effect. Similar to the previous scene, I have set up a simple camera animation. My goal is to animate the objects appearing as the camera flies from one end of the room to the other. Now I'm going to add the animated phasing effect. Then I'll animate these four objects first. For these objects, I will set the animation type to skydrop. Then increase the ease in and stagger it to about 0.8. However, I do not like the order of how the objects are appearing. I want them to appear in a specific order. So here's a tip. When selecting objects, you can choose to stagger in the order in which the objects are selected. This means that the object which is selected first will appear first. That looks good. But the objects are dropping a bit too fast. So I'll increase the duration to 2 seconds. and that looks better. Let's go back to the movie mode and see how it looks. For the start time of the phasing animation, I'll delay it to 1 second. Looks good. Next, I will animate this group of objects here. To do that, I can click here to add another phasing animation. Then I can adjust the start time and duration of it. Then I'll add these objects. When selecting, make sure you have the right category selected. For the animation type, I'll leave it as pop in. And again, I'll adjust the ease in and stagger like so. There we go, just repeat this process for other objects in the scene. Feel free to try different types of animation to see what works best for your scene. For example, I will use the implode effect for these tables and chairs. You can see that the animation is a bit too fast. This is because the speed is also affected by the move distance. Below it, you can see the invisible before start switch, which allows you to make the objects invisible before the start of the animation. If you turn it off, then you can see the starting point of each object. This is very useful when you're adjusting the move distance. When I'm done adjusting the move distance, I can switch this on again. That looks better. When creating multiple groups of animation, you can use these buttons to move them up and down like so. And also, remember to name the different phasing animations to keep everything organized. As you can see, creating multiple groups of phasing animation will allow you to control objects' types of animation, start time, and duration to make it perfectly fit your style. You can even add some dynamic camera movements to make animations like this. And that's how you can use the animated phase-in effect to create animated interior and exterior scenes in Lumia. Leave a like if you enjoyed the video, comment below if you have any suggestions. Stay inspired guys, and I'll see you next time.